2 weeks later, welcome back, guys. After a lot blood, sweat and tears, we finally finished the development for the Lamborghini Urus. Actually, it was really, really challenging, as we have like 4 scent sensors. I explained scent in one of the last videos. And by the way, if you want to check out like the Lamborghini Urus in stock conditions, we're gonna put that video somewhere around there. About the tuning for the Urus, actually 4 times scent, latest scent technology to transmit like sensor signals, 2 times the turbo pressure sensor, and camshaft to get the RPM. Why we are connecting to the RPM sensor, I explained that quickly. As soon as we are developing a software for an engine, as the software is like developed for an engine, we're gonna map it against RPM, and it is load dependent, so we have like more ways to make the tune perfect. So we can map against the RPM, we can map against the load, so actually tuning is RPM and load dependent, which actually helps to like make it more fun to drive and also gain a little bit more performance. And it helps also to keep all the values in a safe area. In terms of performance, we are looking now, we can switch over here. We are looking now at 708 horsepower corrected, 704 horsepower non-corrected, and 950 newton meters of torque, which is an increasement by around 50 horsepower and 100 newton meters of torque. As you can see, the lines are pretty, like the thin line is the stock value, stock torque. Thick line is tuning, also for the engine power, which is red. Thin line is stock, the thick line is tuning. Also here you can see the power on the wheels, thin line is stock, thick line is tuning. Basically, we kept like the design of the engine, how it transmit the torque and the power. It's basically the same, just like 100 newton meters more. Same for the performance. It is all over the RPM area. Of course, during the development, we are checking all the important values like lambda, ignition timing and everything. And to be sure that the tuning is perfect and you can have a lot of fun with your Urus. Or also, of course, we are not doing that just for the Urus, we're doing that on all the cars. So the tune is safe, reliable, and you have a lot of fun with it. We kept the torque below 1000 as the gearbox is not allowed to go over 1000 newton meters of torque. So we gave it a little bit more room to play, 950 newton meters of torque. As I said, it took a lot of time to develop the product, and actually we had to do some modifications to the product itself. So the final product release will be around calendar week 20 to 21 for the Lamborghini Urus. So it should be pretty soon in our shop. So I would like to mention one more thing. We do got a lot of questions about the different mappings, because we are offering like 7 different mappings on the GTS Black and 6 mappings on the RSS example. What is the difference between those mappings? I just like put different mappings on the dyno chart. The thick line, as we saw just a couple of minutes ago, is mapping 7. The pointed line is mapping 5, and the thin line is mapping 0, so stock. So that is basically the difference between those mappings. You can see here, you have a lot more power in higher RPM, a lot more torque in mapping 7. And also here in terms of horsepower. And obviously, if you have more horsepower, you have more wheel power. So you can see those lines are actually like the same horsepower and wheel power. But on mapping 5, it's getting a lot less than in mapping 7, especially in the higher RPM situations. So that is basically the main difference between those mappings. Of course, all the mappings are developed on our dyno and tested on the street for each engine. So I would say, let's go on the Autobahn and see how fast the Urus will be, 100 to 200. So welcome back, guys. We are on the way to the Autobahn. Unfortunately, we are in a traffic jam. Yeah, anyway, to give you an update how the Urus behaves with the tune and in stock. When it comes down to the handling, the car feels really, really amazing and not like a typical SUV, I would say. It feels more like an M5 or an E63. You don't feel you are sitting in an SUV. It definitely feels like a sports car. And Lamborghini promised actually
that the Urus will feel like in a real sports car. GTS Black power increase. We are sitting now at around 705 horsepower around that area and 950 newton meters of torque. Really excited for the 100 to 200 times, which we are going to measure as soon as we are out of that awful traffic jam. So let's see how fast we will be with the GTS Black. So we did a couple of stock runs, confirmed it with our tool, which is called Draggy, that everything is perfect in line and you are not uphill or downhill. So we are running constantly around 9 seconds, which is incredible fast if you consider you are sitting in an SUV. Now we are activating the tune, so let's see how fast we will be with the race GTS Black. So we are done with the time measurement and I'm honestly impressed. This is in serious fast SUV in stock 100-200, 9 seconds, which is incredible fast in my opinion for a 2.2 tons car. With the Racer GTS Black we managed to get the time down by 1 second to 7.95 to be exact, which is overall a really nice improvement and you can definitely feel the difference between stock and tune. Yeah, that's it from us. That's it from the Urus. I think this is the last episode with the Urus. So, yeah, stay tuned for the next cars. See you in one of the next episodes.